Okay, good evening. It's Mr. Dave here again. How is everybody? I am fine. Thank you for asking. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, please. Please. Thank you. I always forget to do it at the start. I always remember at the end, but at the start is the better place. Thumbs up. Come on. Hit that thumbs up button. No. Come on. Minus 16 last night. Oh, yeah. It was supposed to snow, too, but yeah, just a little bit. Yeah, nothing accumulated. But this front window was completely, all the water on it was completely frozen. When I was wiping it off, even after it started to melt, it turned to ice right away again. It was like crazy. But yeah, lots of frozen water. Actually, the door jamb back in the back here, right here along this edge, was actually dripping water last night on me, and got my sleeping bag wet all down one side. Luckily it didn't drip into my boots, because my boots are right there. But anyways, I woke up and I could feel water all the way down there. I was like, what the frig? Did I leave the window open or something? But nope, wasn't that. It was water dripping off of this edge in the door back there. So I don't get that. So yeah, I'm gonna have to figure out some way of not having that happen, because when it's really cold out, any amount of moisture like that's gonna make you super cold. Plus it'll never dry out, you know what I mean? If that happened night after night after night, my sleeping bag's gonna be soaking wet every night. I haven't checked it to see if it dried, but I doubt it did. But anyways, it was really weird. It was like, what the frig? You know, where's the water coming from? Anyways, same thing today. I go back to the locker and I look down at the floor and I go, what? Why is there a puddle of water on the floor? And I'm thinking, there was a bottle of water sitting there. And I was thinking, oh, it must have a hole in it. So I squeezed it. No water came out. Where the water came from was, I had unplugged the refrigerator, the bar fridge, in the locker, and yeah, everything in there thawed out, which is really weird because it was minus 16 outside. So that goes to show you how warm the locker actually would be at night. But anyways, there's nothing in there really, mayonnaise maybe, that could actually go bad. My milk. I never thought to check the milk. The milk should be fine, though. But anyways, that's where the water was coming from. The freezer completely defrosted. Not that there was very much frost in there, but there was water droplets on the bottom of the freezer compartment. And all that melted, dripped down into the bottom of the fridge, and then ran out through the door. So that's where the water was coming from in the locker. I was like, what the frig? Anyways, I keep saying to myself, check everything, because that's not the first time I've done that. I keep saying to myself, check everything before you leave the locker. Make sure everything's on that's, or plugged in that's supposed to be plugged in. Even the warming cabinet, I had unplugged it because I was charging the battery before I left. Or, you know, checking to see if it charged. I can't remember what yesterday was like. I think I got a full charge yesterday, but anyways, I had those two things unplugged to make sure it wouldn't pop the breaker, and forgot to plug them in. I was in such a hurry. Yeah, like last night I left early, right? I ate my pizza. I think it was yesterday. Yeah. I ate my pizza, and then I was in such a hurry to get out of there Anyways, yeah. So it's like it's a mental thing. You gotta remind yourself. I have a note that I put on my desk that says plug in the fridge, but normally I put it on top of my phone so that I don't forget it without, you know, I should put it where the lock is, where the padlock is. But anyway, so I've been watching Battlestar Galactica. So yeah, I was using my phone. I couldn't put the plug in the fridge note on top of my phone. So yeah, stupid, stupid me. But anyways, Battlestar Galactica, I'm done. I watched all of all four seasons. So I don't know how long that took me, but not very long. It, you know, it was great last night. Watched about three episodes in the back here, and yeah, then packed her and went to sleep. So now I've got all five or seven, I can't remember, but all the seasons of Miami Vice. Now I've watched that a couple times. Used to take it with me when I went camping, and I would put it up on a big screen, big 100-inch screen, in my campsite. People would come from all around to watch, and I had that's why I bought the Edifer speakers, was to have really nice sound, right? So yeah, Miami Vice tonight. Tubbs and Crockett. Yeah, only this time I brought the laptop. The laptop will run off of USB. It's got a USB charger, so I can just plug it into the solar charger system there and use electricity from that. I did not kill the battery last night. Amazingly enough, I did the same thing I did the night before, which was use the electric blanket. I think three times I turned it on. So, I don't know, three times? Yeah, three times. So, anyways, didn't kill the battery. So, it was cool in there. Again, put the blanket over my head, or the sleeping bag over my head. I wear this hoodie so that I can put this up like this. And then I tie the drawstring around so it's around me good and tight like this so it doesn't come off in the middle of the night. I know, Takita Science had mentioned don't just wear a canvas hat, but no, I use the hat actually to cover up the LEDs that are on the solar system, right? Because they will light up the whole, not, you know, tremendously, but they light up the back of the vehicle. So yeah, I use the hat to cover those up so like they can't be seen. Especially if someone came and started looking in the window, right? You don't want them seeing anything at all. So I put my cell phone face down, so because I've got the real time or the clock showing all the time on the screen. Even my little portable radio, I put it right here. Well, you can't see, but no. Better make sure I click that twice to make sure I don't kill the battery. Anyways, yeah, I put it right in between the headrest and the seat. There's a little gap. I just shove it in there and I make sure the display is down. So nobody can see any LEDs or anything lit up in the back. And speaking of the Huawei P20 Pro, I called the Virgin Mobile today and I got the, because my contract was up on the 28th, my data and everything renews on the midnight of the 5th. Today is the 2nd. I wanted to make sure I renewed and everything and upgraded the phone. So I got the Sapphire Blue. Which I really, you know, anyways, I should have got the black, but Anyways, I got the Sapphire Blue P30 Pro with the wireless charger. I'll be able to wireless charge again, no more cords. I love it. Anyways, it's 8 gigs of RAM and I believe 128 gig of ROM storage. So that will be good. And it will be here in a couple days. It's already shipped. I called them about 2 o'clock, got a notice about 7 p.m. that Bell had shipped it to me. Why Bell would be shipping me a Virgin phone is beyond my brain, but that's where Virgin gets their signal from, is a Bell network. So yeah, should be here in a couple days at my postal drop box. I got another repair today. It was somebody local, not too far away from here, and they're going to be dropping it off tomorrow. That's $156. So the cash will be in the box, and basically it'll take me about 20 minutes to fix it. And I already know what's wrong with it, and I know exactly what to do, and get that done and get it back to them. What else? Good news today. What else? What else? I went into my Amazon account to order another heater, and I wanted to get a pair of Sherpa fleece slippers to put on my feet because I find the socks don't work the best. They're not very thick. And they're a pain in the rear to get on and off, so I figured a pair of slippers would be better. You know, they're like tight around the feet. So I got a pair of those that were like $15, and the heater, and oh, a couple of little USB-C adapters, USB-C to USB-A, you know, regular USB 3.0 plug. So I can plug my memory stick into the new phone and, you know, transfer stuff like I've been doing, you know, with the Battlestar Galactica. Anyways, I go in to place the order and it says I got a $25 promotional credit or something like that. I'm like, what? What's that for? Anyways, so yeah, I used it. Amazon, they're kind of weird. Like, I don't get those guys. But anyways, Amazon too. Like, the padded, the 3-inch upholstery padding that I bought, 6 feet by 2 feet, wasn't very expensive. It was like $65 or something like that, and I've been sleeping on it for 40 days, like 40 whatever days, right? Like, it's like, what the? Anyways, I get a notification from Amazon saying that the package never arrived and they're sending me a refunding me my money. So I go in and look at the tracking. It says it was delivered. Like, what? I never asked for them to do that. But yeah, they gave me back the $65 plus tax or whatever back on my credit card. I'm like, what the frig is with you guys? And you know what? It's always stuff that's been delivered by Canada Post. It's never their delivery people because it's always Canada Post. For some reason, Canada Post gets lazy and they don't scan the tracking number, I guess, or whatever. Anyways, it says it's delivered. But they did that a little while ago when I made that cedar bed frame. I ordered a 10-inch pocket coil mattress, the twin XL for that bed frame that I made, and they shipped it, big box, things heavy as can be, but it's rolled, it's compressed, it's rolled up. So I just left it in the box because I'm not gonna need that until I get a place. Same thing with that, like a 3 weeks later or whatever, they said, oh, you never got the package, we're gonna give you your money back. Well, that thing was $200 and something. You know what I mean? So yeah, thanks, Amazon. Thank you. Same thing with that little hot pot. I complained to them. I said, you know, the seller says it's 200 watts. It's not. It's 340 watts. And it's supposed to be 200 and 600. It's actually 340 and 780. They gave me my money back. I said, keep it. I'm like, what? And seriously, that's what it draws. So, and that was the manufacturer. I complained in the comments, the review, and then the manufacturer emailed me and said, yeah, I think I mentioned this before, right? They said, oh, you must be running it off a higher voltage if it's drawing that much current. I said, you know, even if it's a 10 volt, you know, you're saying it works off 110. I got it running on 120, let's say. 10 volts difference isn't going to make it draw almost twice what you're saying it draws. Like, it's no, it wouldn't. To be almost twice, it would have to be 220 that I'm powering it off of. Anyways, so they gave me my money back. Thank you. So, yeah. Amazon, like. And then AliExpress, I mean, I've had stuff that, the connectors that I ordered, it's supposed to be two sets of 10, male and female, 10. I ordered 5 of those. They sent me 10 and 10. So I complained and I said, well, you only sent me, you know, a total of 10 pairs and I ordered 50 pairs. Anyways, they said, prove it. I'm like, well, how can I prove it? I take a picture of the front of the packing thing that says how much the weight is, and you can go by the weight, like, you know, whatever. If it's 100 grams, it should be 500 grams because I ordered 5 times the order, right? Anyways, I lost my money on that. I paid like $20 for 50 pairs, so that's 100, you know, 40 pin headers. Yeah, they basically stole my money. So I gave them an earful, and I said, I'm not ordering anything from you people ever again. Then I ordered, at the same time, I had ordered 2 AC temperature controllers and 2 more of the DC ones. I got the AC ones, okay, but the DC ones I never got. So again, I put in opened a dispute. They said, prove to us that you haven't got them yet. It says they're in the destination country. I haven't got them. Tracking number still says I haven't gotten them. Anyways, again, got ripped off there. So, AliExpress, kiss my fat rear end, will you please? You guys are nothing but crooks now. You used to be honest. You would just step right in there and give people their money back if they got screwed. You guys are just ridiculous. So, no more AliExpress. I can tell you that right now. And I got nothing good to say about AliExpress. That's twice in a month and a half that you ripped me off. So, yeah, eat my shorts there, you idiots. And they've actually, you know, seen some of my videos on here about stuff from AliExpress and went, oh, thanks for the review and blah, 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 blah. Well, I hope you're watching this, AliExpress, because you're a bunch of crooks. Don't buy anything from there. They've totally gone downhill as far as support goes. And if it's because of COVID that things aren't getting here now, well, you know, maybe you shouldn't have spread it all around the world. Like, come on. China, thank you very much. Anyways, that's a rant for today. So yeah, thanks Amazon. Thanks for the $25 credit. Thanks for the $65 credit. I'm sleeping on it every night. So yeah, I don't know how you guys work. I really don't. There's another job opportunity. I did see it once, but I haven't been able to find it again, and that was do deliveries for Amazon in Peterborough here. They were looking for delivery drivers to work for the I forget what it's called now, Intelcom. But can't find it now. I should have applied the minute I saw it. Wished I lived in Toronto because I don't know if I'd want to work for Amazon. Running around their big warehouse picking up stuff and getting minimum wage. Anyways. No luck on the job front at all. I got a notification today from Indeed about a job I applied for 14 days ago and still nothing. So after 2 weeks, they, give you an email notification saying you applied for this job. We'll let you know when something transpires or whatever. But yeah, it said 14 days ago. So yeah, I have applied to probably 15 different places now and absolutely nothing. Anyways. Trying to think of something that I can do myself and not have to worry about, that, but anyways, at least I got some work coming tomorrow. So tonight's gonna be another cold night. It's going down to minus 11 tonight, which after surviving at minus 16, minus 11 shouldn't be too bad. Now what I'm not looking forward to is when it hits minus 20 or minus 25. That's gonna be scary, scary. But yeah, the electric blanket seems to work pretty good. Get underneath that bed shirt, fleece blanket, and the 15 minus 15 degree woods sleeping bag, and you have that electric blanket underneath me. Yeah, it works good. The only thing is the electric blanket keeps moving off to one side, so I got to keep putting it back in the center. It was kind of not very warm the other night, and then I looked the next day, and sure enough, it had slid right off the side. So I need to keep an eyeball on that. Keep all that stuff stacked up, and keep it all nice and neat and the way it should be. And that's something I need to tend to every couple of days. The big issue right now still is my feet. My feet were freezing last night and I had the socks on, so I'm gonna get these Sherpa. They say they're like warm socks or whatever, but they're, they actually look like a shoe, but they're soft knitted on the outside, Sherpa on the inside. Hopefully they don't come off in the middle of the night, but yeah, size 11 to 12. They should be like buying a sock. They should fit. So hopefully I don't kick those babies off. But anyways, if they don't work, they're going back to Amazon, that's for sure. And something like that that's less than $25, I find that if you don't want it, they tell you just to keep it because it's not worth you shipping it on their dime back to them. So, if they don't work, I will be requesting a refund. And the other heater assembly, it's the same as what's in the car here. 200 watt, 12 volt. So what I'm going to do is I've already wired up a power supply, switching power supply, and I'm going to try and make some kind of heating arrangement for in the locker. Even if it brings the temperature up a wee bit, I'm going to do that, and it'll be something that I turn on and off. The cement floor really transfers the cold, so my feet get cold just sitting there during the day. So what I ended up doing was taking a piece of that foam insulation and putting it on the floor in front of my chair. So my feet are actually on insulation, and that worked. That kept my feet warm today. Oh, the other thing I forgot to do was the drawing of my solar system here. I've still got to do that. Okay, I haven't forgotten. Like I said, I'm gonna do it and do it in a video. So, yeah, it's coming. I forget who asked about that, but it's coming. If you watch this, I promise you will see it sooner or later. Probably in the next couple days. So anyways, tomorrow, it's supposed to only go to about 5 degrees, but the day after that, it's gonna be plus 12 during the day. So it'll be a nice day a couple days from now. The sun was out all nice today and everything. I got a full charge off the solar panels today. I think it said they made 380 watts, and I'm up to 7,500 kilowatt hours produced. So that's pretty good. That's energy I can use to keep myself warm at night. I actually plugged in the charger and it went right to 100% and turned off. So the batteries were completely charged. Yeah, lots of sun today until now. And now it's pouring rain again. And it's supposed to snow tonight again. Probably won't, because they say, yeah, it may. Yeah, minus 11 it's supposed to go down to with the wind chill. So, last night, it was cold and the wind was just, it was shaking my vehicle. It was like you could just hear it howling outside. Yeah. But I was inside watching my Battlestar Galactica and having a ball. Well, no, not having a ball, but anyways, I keep the water in the car here. I got an extra bottle here, and I got another one in the back. The problem is, if you drink it, then you gotta go pee, right? So, by the time I am ready to go to bed, it's time to pee, but then it's already cool inside the back. Oh, I brought the temperature thingy last night with me, and believe it or not, it was 23 when I got in and 10 in the back when I went to go to sleep. So, and it was quite cold outside, but I use the infrared temperature thing just to check the temperature on the windows and stuff like that. So I believe this morning when I checked it, it was zero. So that was after the sun had come up, probably warmed up, and I was just, aiming at the reflectix. So that could be, some heat transfer from the reflectix. But yeah, so tonight it's gonna be Miami Vice. So yeah, get to see the crocodile. Yeah, so on. This is the last of my lemonade that I made. So tonight, I'm debating on which location to go to. I'm thinking of doing Stealth Location 2 tonight, or the Location 3 that I've been at once now. I'm probably gonna go to 2, Stealth Location 2, for no particular reason. Location 1's getting a little crowded at night. When I went there last night, there were people sitting in their cars. I really don't want anybody seeing me getting in the back. So I repositioned myself and sat in the car. I had a couple cigarettes until one of them drove away. Then the other one, I could see them in the vehicle, but They didn't have the lights on or anything like that. So, but anyways, I kind of repositioned myself so that all they would see me doing is get out of my vehicle. And I don't think they'd be able to tell whether I got back in the front or the back. But, yeah. So, yeah, that's why I'm going to location number two tonight, because generally if I go there after 11 o'clock, there's absolutely nobody around, except for the, no cars around except for the transport truck cab. So I just park beside it like I normally do. It kind of gives me some shielding to the weather, the wind. Yeah, so that'll be the plan tonight. I didn't really cook anything tonight. And I really wanted some protein. So my plan was to go to Costco and buy the $8 pre-cooked chicken. Rotisserie chicken. You know, last time I bought it, it lasted me 4 nights. Even 5, I think it was. You know, so for $8, that's pretty cheap. And, you know, it's good. You don't have to worry about heating it. I like eating chicken while it's cold. I was looking forward to eating warm chicken tonight. And I got there and there were none. So, my backup plan, because I usually go there around 7:30, 8 o'clock, so there's no lineup, so it was around 7:30 anyway. So I went over and got a Polish sausage and you know, the drink. Haven't even drank it yet, still sitting here. Again, if I drink it, I'm gonna end up having to pee, so yeah, better drink it soon though, so that I get it through the system. And I don't know where this came from, but I found it in my car today. This beautiful oak leaf. Look at that. So it was on the floor in the driver's seat. So I'm going to keep this. I'm going to keep this as a memorabilia. You can see through that. Almost see through it. I'm going to keep this for a memorabilia of my stealth camping experience. Hopefully, yeah. If it doesn't get all dried out and start breaking. But I'm going to find somewhere in here where I can attach it and just leave it there. So, hoping that it'll absorb some of the moisture every night. You know what I mean? But, yeah. So, yeah, tonight I got the 15.6-inch screen on the Chewy laptop, and I'll be able to watch, like, almost like having a little TV there, right? So I got it in the back. I also brought my hard drive, which has, you know, it's a one terabyte hard drive, so it's got a whole bunch of movies on it and stuff, and I think it's got Shameless and Breaking Bad, Sons of Anarchy. It's got the whole whack, so if I start watching Miami Vice and think, oh gee, I've already seen this before, I don't want to watch this, I'll switch over to something else. But that's my game plan tonight. And it's already 10:30. This isn't an early it's not an early video tonight, but as soon as I'm done this and I upload it, I'll be heading over to stealth location number two. The guy beside me here is listening to what I'm saying, so yeah, I got an audience. Oh, and you guys, right? So, and what else? What else? What else? What else? I don't even know what night this is. Is it night 51? Oh, wow. It's like we're almost at 60. Hmm. Going back to the cell phone, I got a loyalty package, 20 gigabyte a month. I'm on the plan I'm on now is 5. So I got the 10 gigabyte plan and they gave me 10 free loyalty. So I'll have, actually, they've already transferred it to this phone. Because I've paid my bill already this month, and you know there's a week between the 28th and the 5th of I don't know, that's how they do their billing cycle or whatever. So the guy said to me, oh, don't worry about running out of data before your new phone comes, because I'm already upgrading you to the 20 gig on the old phone, so don't worry. So yeah, I haven't seen that yet, like it, my numbers haven't changed, but if it's true, I might do a video right from the vehicle again, like I did the first night. And I still have 1.8 gig left on the old plan, which has got to last me for another 3 days. Well, got to remember to check and see if I turn the data off before I upload. Make sure I don't use my data to actually upload it. But anyways, yeah, 20 gig a month. Can you believe that? Wow, that's a lot. I can watch porn from the back. No. Nope. Yeah. So, yeah, had a Polish sausage for dinner. That's all. What I should have got was the poutine as well, but nope. Conserve the dollarinos, right? So, yeah, that was my day. Again, I'm going to ask, if you did something important today, please put it in the comments so that I can hear about your life. I don't like it all being about me. So it would be nice to hear what's happening to other people. All right. Yeah. So, as usual, at this time, I must say, again, please give me a thumbs up. If you please be so kind, that would be nice. If you have any questions, comments, or want to tell me what your daily experience was like, put it in the comments below. I'll be glad to read it and respond to it. Also, if by any chance you're not a subscriber, I would appreciate it very much if you would subscribe to my channel. If you hit the little bell button, you'll get a notification anytime I upload a new video. Also, my regular subscribers, thanks for watching. If you've watched all the way this far to the end, I really, really appreciate that. Yeah, so it's Dave over and out. Again, for this evening. Thanks for watching, everyone. Have a great night.